So Slate Digital have just released another plugin to their already immense lineup of plugins. This is another module for the virtual mix rack, and it's Slate's take on the formidable Pultec equalizer. The question is, do we need it, and is it any good? Let's find out. Alright, so the Pultec. These things have been around since forever, and it is probably one of, if not the most famous equalizer in the world. As you can imagine, a lot of different companies have emulated or sought to emulate the Pultec. Universal Audio, Antelope Audio, Avid, Native Instruments, and many more I'm probably forgetting. Almost every decent plugin company has a Pultec. So, the first question that brings to mind is, why would Slate bother to do this? It's probably one of the most emulated pieces of hardware ever. But, there we go, Slate has decided to throw their hat in the ring with a Pultec emulation. Is it any good? Well, not sure yet. We're about to find out together, because you'll be hearing it at the same time I am, for the first time, because I want to give you my gut reaction to how this sounds. So I've installed it, I've updated, but I purposefully haven't opened it. Let's go and jump into Pro Tools and let's have a listen and see what we've got. So this is the Slate SD-PE1, and once you've updated Virtual Mix Rack, you'll see it appear at the bottom here. My usual go-to for this type of thing would be the UAD. I always use the UAD one because it sounds absolutely fantastic. So this is the one I'm going to be comparing against because it's the one that I'm the most familiar with. Now, if you didn't look at the Audioscape video I did with the real Pultec, check that one out as well. I'll stick a link up here, it's cool. Let's have a listen to our baseline, which is the UAD version. Sometimes you have a dream, but the world's out of heaven when you tell us between. Okay, so as you can hear there, I'm boosting 2 dB at 100, and I'm boosting 3 at 10k. That's what we're going to do with the Slate. So, Slate is up, and 10k, let's boost 3, and 100, let's boost 2. Cool. I do notice on the Slate one, they have included 70 Hz. Which the original does not have. The original only has 60 and 100, whereas this one has 70 as well. That's kind of cool. They've also added 40. That's nice. Let's have a listen off the bat. How does it sound? You're the one that you slowed right down. Far too fickle in all this row. Interesting. Let me just flick between the two. You're the one that you slowed right down. Far too fickle in all this row. The grave awaits you nearly home. What's the use in being dead or alone? Sometimes you have a dream, but the world's out of heaven when your tail's between your feet. Other times I turn back around. It's clear to me that you know what you're gonna find. Is anyone else hearing that? That sounds like shit. And that can't be... No, this can't be right. You're the one that you slowed right down. Far too fickle in all this row. The grave awaits you nearly home. What's the use of being dead or alone? Sometimes you have a dream, but the world's out of heaven when your tail's between your feet. Other times... Okay, so what I'm hearing, the UAD Pultec adds this sheen, this excitement, this butteriness almost, you know, which you would kind of expect from a Pultec. I'm adding a little bit of low, I'm adding a little bit of top, and it kind of, you can almost perceive the EQ curve in the mix just kind of shining a little bit. In comparison, it sounds to me like the Slate Pultec just makes everything woolly. Like, with the exact same settings, it's woolly sounding. And it almost sounds less 3D. Almost like it monoizes things slightly. How weird. Alright, let's see if we can match the two. That's kind of closer, but that's boosting nearly 6 into 10k and less in the low end. But to me, that boost into that top end boost, it doesn't sound particularly pleasing. It sounds brittle. Whereas if we flip back to the UAD version. I can boost that a lot more and it doesn't collapse. That's quite shocking to me. The reason for that is because Slate plugins are usually pretty good. Cool, the 70Hz band is nice, but does it pull tech? No, it does not. Alright, so I didn't start out on this video with the idea of being purposefully negative. As I say, I am a fan of Slate's plugins, generally speaking, hence I pay my own money for the bundle. None of this is sponsored, I haven't been given any of these plugins, I've paid for them all out of my own pocket. My thoughts. If you're in the market and you don't have a Pultec plugin at all, and you're looking to get your first one and you've already got the Slate bundle, is it usable? Yes, it is usable. Just don't be expecting miracles, but it is usable. I guess there's a line from that James song, isn't there? If I hadn't seen such riches, I could live with being poor. That's how I feel about the Slate Pultec. If I hadn't ever heard the UAD one, or indeed a real one, I'd probably think that was great. And I'm sure a lot of people out there, to them it is great, and that's fine. If, however, you have the choice of getting hold of the UAD version, I would absolutely go for that. I mean, my personal opinion is I just prefer how it sounds. It sounds to me a lot more lifelike, a lot more 3D, a lot more Pultec. How many times can I say Pultec in this video? Cool, bit of a shocker. Wasn't expecting that. I was expecting to be singing the praises of this plugin, as I have done with pretty much all of Slate's other plugins. Thanks a lot for watching and joining me today, and I'll see you guys again in the next video. Take care.